Hi friends, welcome to this class. In this video, we are going to study this Witt's theory to tell why dyes are colors, right? So, according to Witt's theory, these dyes are there, right? These are colored because they contain some functional groups which have multiple bonds, right? They contain some functional groups which have multiple bonds. I mean, it can have double bond or triple bond, right? Multiple bonds, because of which these dyes are colored. So this functional group which have these multiple bonds, he called it as chromophores. So what are these chromophores? Chromophores are nothing but organic compound, or I can call it as a functional group which contain multiple bonds, right? Because of these chromophores, he called these dyes will be colored, right? So let us see few examples of these chromophores. So let me take the book so that I should not leave any of the example, right? So first example, so this is nitro. See, examples for this chromophores, right? These are the examples for chromophores. So nitro means here, N will be there, double bond O. Some people write this nitro group like this also. Some people will write like this. So they will make this coordinate dative bond. They will make it, no problem. If you are comfortable like this also, no problem, right? It's good only, because valency of nitrogen is 3 and it will be having one lone pair. But here it has involved all the 5 valency. In actual speaking, it follows only octet rule, but here I have written expanded octet. It's wrong, but still, if you are comfortable, you can write it. But the exact structure will be this one, right? So this thing, if you know, then you can write also. It's no problem, right? So nitro group is a chromophore, right? So other things like azo group, these we have discussed. Azo means N double bond, N will be there. So it acts also chromophore. Why is act as chromophore? Here also see, unsaturation is there, double bond, multiple bonds. Here also see, nitrogen oxygen pi bond is there, right? So this bond can be helps in resonance. How it happens, everything we shall see with this video. So azo groups, nitro group and nitroso group, nitroso like N double bond O. This is nitroso, right? These all act as my chromophores. And this carbonyl, see, double bond O is there. And I have this benzoquinoid. See here, this is the structure. Benzene ring is there, right? So here I'll do like this, double bond O. So this is para-benzoquinoid. This is also colored because, right? So these all act as chromophores, right? So definition of chromophores also you have understood, right? So this is, and I have this ortho, see here, double bond here, right? Further, double bond here, one double bond, and here one double bond, right? This is what, this is nothing but my ortho quinonoid. So this is, right, I hope you are getting. If this is there, see here, instead of O, if I remove that, so I wrote it wrongly, just to make it like this. So this acts as a chromophore and the name is para-quinonoid. So this is ortho-quinonoid. Just to see the structure, here double bond, single bond, double bond, here a single bond, double bond, right? Ortho-quinonoid, this is para-quinonoid, right? So this is about the chromophores. So because of these chromophores which are having multiple bonds, the dyes will be colored according to this theory, right? That statement you write by yourself. And these were the few examples of this chromophores, right? So we discussed what are chromophores, examples of chromophores. Let us see how these impact color to the dyes. That thing we shall see. What is this? This is my benzene, right? So this is benzene. If you see the color of benzene, it will be colorless, right? To this, I will add some chromophores, NO2. So NO2 is a chromophore. So structure, it like this, right? So what happens here, the resonance happens like this. Because of this resonance, what happens, this will be pale yellow color. Initially benzene is colorless, but here when I added this chromophore, it become pale yellow color. You may ask why it happens, sir, right? So this is the thing, why it happens, that thing I have to explain now. So what happens here, benzene is there. For benzene, it will be having this HOMO and LUMO. HOMO means highest occupied molecular orbital, LUMO means lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. So here there will be electrons. To do this transition, we need to apply radiation whose energy is equivalent to this energy, between this energy, then only transition occurs. So if you see that radiation, its energy will be less than 400 nanometer. Less than 400 nanometer means we can't see that radiation. For example, for this it will be around for millimeter 275 nanometer, let us put. So 275, it never falls in 400 to 800 nanometer visible region. So benzene is colorless. Whereas when we introduce nitro group, what happens, as soon as we introduce nitro group, this LUMO will come down, because of which the distance between HOMO and LUMO, this is my HOMO and this is LUMO, it decreases as energy decreases, right? We know that we know this equation, E is equal to h nu, E is equal to hc by lambda. From this it is clear that energy is directly proportional to frequency, but inversely proportional to wavelength. As energy decreases, wavelength increases, right? Initially when energy was this much, the wavelength was 275 nanometer, but here energy decreased, so wavelength will increase. I will tell it will increase to 450 nanometer, sorry, it is nanometer. So it is falling in visible region. So 450 nanometer, I have told, do like this, VBGYOR. So 450 means around, it is lying near violet color. So complementary, it will be yellow color. So it appears pale yellow color. So why it happened? Because of this chromophore. What is that? Nitro group. Because of this nitro group, the energy between HOMO and LUMO decreased, because of which energy required for transition decreased. So wavelength increased, because energy and wavelength are inversely proportional, right? So we will get this yellow color, right? So initially benzene was colorless, now we got pale yellow color. So this is the thing, what all the thing happens, the chemistry behind it, I have explained it nicely, right? So let us see few examples. So let me write here, this is what, this we have studied, I think, benzene ring. Here N is the double bond N, and here benzene ring, right? So the name of this is the azo benzene, right? Azo group is there, azo benzene. So if you see, it appears red. So the substance appears red means which color it will absorb, can you tell? See, I have the same thing, complementary color, go for that, VBGYOR. So it appears red, it appears red means it will absorb green color, right? So green wavelength it will absorb, so it appears red. Like that you should remember, you should make use of this thing, right? So this azo benzene will appear red. So here azo, this N double bond N is there, right? So this acts as a chromophore, right? So one more example, so this one, double bond O. So the name of this is para benzo quinone. So this is nothing but para benzo quinone. So it appears yellow color. Whereas this ortho benzo quinone, so this structure you should know. Ortho benzo quinone means adjacent ortho position, single bond double bond here, single bond double bond here, like this, right? So this is ortho, other things benzo quinone same, but it appears orange red. So these all colors is due to this chromophores. Here these are the chromophores, here N2 is chromophore, here NO2 is chromophore. Whereas here benzene was colorless, but this was also having chromophore. We call this C double bond, C is also chromophore, but it could not, its wavelength is not lying in visible region, that is 400 to 800 nanometer. So benzene is colorless, right? I hope you got it. So I explained about HOMA and LUMO things, but again I will take one more example so that it will be clear for you, right? So I have this CH2 double bond CH2 ethylene, right? So alkene, ethylene it is. So its nanometer, if you see, it will be around 170 nanometer, right? It will absorb lambda max, right? So if you take this one, 1,3-butadiene, right? Same like this, I have added one more compound with sigma bond. So I will get this one, CH2 double bond CH2 single bond CH double bond CH2. So it is 1,3-butadiene. If you see, it will be 270 nanometer. So I told this double bond acts as a chromophore, right? But this is a weak chromophore, whereas those NO2, N double bond, NO, right? All these are strong chromophore, whereas this C double bond C is there, right? It is a weak chromophore, right? Weak chromophore. See, here also it is increasing, but they have given that here, if I have like this CH double bond CH for 6 times, and here methyl is there, and here also methyl. So what I am doing, so I am increasing the conjugation. Conjugation means here only double bond, now here double bond, single bond, double bond, conjugation is there. Similarly, I have used conjugation such that I should get this pair 6 times. If I see its color, it was yellow, right? So it means it is absorbing 450 nanometer, right? It absorbs 450 nanometer and appears yellow. Means it absorbs violet color, it appears yellow, right? So what I am doing, see here, simply I am adding this double bond, that in conjugation form. So initially it was 170 nanometer, further it 270 nanometer, both were colorless because I can't see this, as these are lies in UV region, not visible region. But here it absorbs at 450 nanometer, which is visible region. So it absorbs violet light and appears yellow. So I can see that. So this is the evidence for this, how it happens. So here I have HOMO, LUMO. Initially this gap is very high, so I should put high energy. High energy means less wavelength. So here it is, wavelength is 170 nanometer. Further, if I increase the conjugation, so the energy gap decreased. So energy decreased, so wavelength increased. So wavelength from 170 nanometer, it increased to 270 nanometer. When I came to this compound, the energy is very decreased. Energy decreased means wavelength increased. So it is around 450 nanometer, which falls in visible region, and I could able to see that, right? So this is the thing, how HOMO, LUMO, right? I have explained there only, and now also here also I have explained. So now it should be clear for you. So this is the Witt's theory, right? So Witt's theory. So in Witt's theory, he told its color is due to this chromophores, right? Further, what he will tell, see, this is benzene, it is colorless. Further to this, I'll add nitrobenzene, and he called it as, it is pale yellow color, pale yellow, and it is because of this chromophore are the substance which is having multiple bonds, right? So chromophore I have. Further what he told, to save this nitrobenzene, what he will do, he will add a para position opposite to that aniline NH2. So the color, it is pale yellow, now its color is intensified, it dark yellow I can call, or it appears orange color, right? Dark yellow or orange color. So this intensifies the color, it is because of this NH2 group. But this NH2 group, if you see, it is like this, here one hydrogen, and here lone pairs, right? No unsaturation is there. Such compounds are, he called it as oxochromes. So now I should give you a definition of oxochromes. Chromophores are what? Chromophores are the substance which have got multiple bonds, right? Because of which they increase the conjugation, and because of which the light appears in visible region. But oxochromes are the substance, right? These don't have multiple bond, but they will intensify the color. Why they will intensify? Because of these lone pairs. So oxochromes, if you see any of the oxochrome, they will be having lone pair. You may ask, sir, why, what happens if they have lone pair, right? So see here it has got lone pair, so it will do conjugation like this. Because of this conjugation, right, the difference between this HOMO and LUMO will be decreased. So as energy decreases, lambda max increases. So initially it was yellow, but because of this NH2 group, it becomes dark yellow. Means wavelength increased. So complementary color will be dark, right? So initially it appears yellow, means it will be violet. It absorbs violet. Further, it absorbs blue light. So initially it was pale yellow, it looks like yellow. When it absorbed blue light, it becomes orange color. Right, I hope you understood it. Right, this is how it will intensify the color. So oxochromes are the substance which has got lone pairs, and they will intensify the color of the chromophores. Right, so oxochromes we always use in presence of chromophore. Right, in some cases directly if we add this sear, aniline will be having some pale yellow color, right? So this is also because of this resonance only, but here it acts as only oxochrome, not chromophore. So here there is chromophore absent, right? So these things you should remember. I hope I have told everything. If I have left anything, yeah, I have left some points. So let me give some examples for this oxochrome, right? So few examples are there. So NH2 I have given, OH, see here, this is also having lone pairs. OH is there, OR is there, same lone pair will be there, OR. NH2 I have given, and phenol OH, benzene ring, phenolic OH, it will be brown color, right? Because of this, OH acts as a oxochrome there. And carboxylic acid, COOH, you may ask, sir, it has got, but it will increase the resonance structure, because of which it acts as a oxochrome, right? So this is about chromophore, oxochrome and Wittig reaction. So Wittig theory, not Wittig reaction, Wittig theory, right? So before going further, let me tell you some things. So here, see, this is benzene, and I told it 273 nanometer it will absorb, right? So to this, if I add nitrobenzene, NO2, it absorbs at 450 nanometer, right? So it appears yellow color, means it absorbs violet light and appears yellow. So what happened? The wavelength has been shifted. From lower wavelength, it has shifted to higher wavelength. Such shift is called as bathochromic shift. Bathochromic shift. Or we can call it as red shift. Why it is called as red shift? Because see here, what I am doing, it is moving towards red side. 800 nanometer is red color. So it is moving from 273, it has moved to 450. So it is near to red color, right? So this shift is called bathochromic shift. If from this, it is nitrobenzene. If I remove this NO2 group, then it becomes colorless. So from yellow color, it becomes colorless. So from 450 nanometer, it comes to 273 nanometer, right? So this shift is called, this red shift is bathochromic shift. The opposite shift is called hypsochromic shift. I hope you understand this. So if wavelength increases, we call it as bathochromic shift or red shift. If the wavelength decreases, we can call it as hypsochromic shift or the blue shift. We call here it as a hypsochromic shift or the blue shift. I hope you got it, right? So this is about bathochromic and hypsochromic shift. See here, absorption, when we always plot absorption versus wavelength, lambda and nanometer. So initially it was observed at 273. So here we get a peak like this, right? When I add nitro group to this, this shifts towards 450 nanometer. So this shift is called as bathochromic shift or red shift. So this shift is called as blue shift, hypsochromic shift or blue shift. If along with that absorption also increases or decreases, right? If it increases, this is called hyperchromic shift, and if it decreases, hypochromic shift. Chromic is constant for everything, shift, right? So here what is there? So here wavelength has remained constant, but absorption has increased. So hyperchromic, decrease means hypochromic. So if wavelength increases, red shift, or we can call it as bathochromic shift. If it is decrease, then we call it as blue shift or the hypsochromic shift, right? So for bathochromic or hypsochromic, within the same example, you can tell that from this to this, this is called bathochromic shift. From here to here, if you do, it is hypsochromic shift. So further to this, if I add one more oxochrome, that is this one, nitro is there, to this NH2 group, if I add, again from pale yellow, it has orange color, right? So this is also called as bathochromic shift. So here to here bathochromic, here to here bathochromic. If I come reverse, it will be hypsochromic, that is blue shift, right? So this is all about this Witt's theory. In next class, let us see one more theory. Till then, take care.